الله بدل يا رجال الله عينونا بعون الله وكونوا عونا لنا بالله عسى بفضل الله. طريقتنا الصحبة والخير في الجمعية. Our way is companionship and goodness in the gatherings. The gatherings with good ones, with pious ones, with people who are seeking Allah's pleasure. I did a program this morning and the interviewer asked me, why should people attend these gatherings, these mawlids? What's in them? I said, it is the sunnah of Sayyidina Muhammad. Sunnah of Sayyidina Muhammad is suhbah. Suhbah is companionship. His companions were his companions because they accompanied him. Islam is not everyone for themselves or everyone for their understanding. It is the sunnah of Sayyidina Muhammad and salawatu rabbi wa salamu alayh. He said, إِذَا مَرَرْتُمْ بِرِيَاضِ الْجَنَّةِ فَارْتَعُوا. That when you pass in the gardens of paradise, when you pass in the gardens of paradise, then go in these gardens. What's in the gardens? Fruits. Beauty. He said, فَارْتَعُوا means consume, fill yourselves. What was he talking about? They asked him, what are these Riyadul Jannah? He said, Hiraq al-Dhikr. He said, the gatherings of remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For our eyes, when we go to a gathering of dhikr or to a mawlid, our eyes are veiled. We see ourselves. We see, we hear ourselves and we see ourselves. We're not seeing the paradise. We're not seeing this gathering or the gatherings of people remembering Allah. We're not seeing what the Prophet ﷺ was seeing. But to his eyes, because he has no restrictions, seen and unseen to him are one. He was seeing the angels, so for his eyes, he is seeing these places where the zikr is happening, where the people are gathering. He was seeing them as gardens of paradise on earth. People now complain. They pay thousands of dollars to go visit a special place. A recreational place, a park in close to Edmonton there, what you call them?
Rockies, Vancouver?
Yeah, Vancouver, there's a famous one. Banff. They pay to go to Banff. Or they pay thousands of dollars to come to Niagara Falls because they want to see something beautiful. They want to experience something new, different, and beautiful. A Prophet ﷺ said, you can step into paradise in this world. You just have to seek out the places of zikr. Mawlid. You think Mawlid, what happens in Mawlid? Dhikr. Salawat is dhikr. Dhikrullah. When you make Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa Sayyidina Muhammad, it's dhikr. And on top of that, honoring the one whom Allah honored. Loving the one whom Allah, remembering the one whom Allah remembered, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. These are not gardens of paradise. If we see the reality, people would be lined up today to enter this place. For zikr. you may have to turn people away. Because who doesn't want to be in paradise? Everyone wants to be in paradise. So the mashayikh, they make this weekly. Once a week, you must attend this gathering. And because the devils and the nafs, the ego, they know, shaitan knows the value of dhikrullah. He also knows. He knows that these were people gathering to say Allah. He sees the angels. The angels come. They know the value of this, so they don't want anybody to attend. That's why whenever you want to do something good, you find so much resistance. And people find so much waswas. Oh, you know, there's this problem, there's that. You have something important, you have to study, all of a sudden. You have to do something. Always. Why the waswas comes? Because Shaitan doesn't want you to go to paradise.
Allah.
He promised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send you to hell. To send us all to hell. He made a pledge. He says, I will show you. I will come from the right, from the left, from the front. I will show you that I will take them off the path. So he tries his best to make these gatherings for people not to attend. But be happy, inshallah, if you are attending dhikrullah, be happy. Be grateful and happy. Because he is Sadiq al-Masduq, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. La yantiqu ani al-hawa, in huwa illa wahyun yuha, Allah says. He doesn't speak from nothing. Revelation. He says, Riyadul Jannah, Hilaqu al-Dhikr, Gardens of Paradise, Amanna wa Saddaqna. Why people die to go to his rawda? Because he says, "Ma bayna qabri wa minbari rawda min riyad al-jannah." But you have when you go to Umrah, alhamdulillah. But before you go to Umrah, may not go to Umrah for a year, 2 years. What do? You don't want to be in paradise. We don't want to be in paradise. We want to be in paradise. So this is why it's important to attend dhikr. And it's important to attend Miladun Nabi also, because sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is our way, our means. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad for entering paradise. He taught us about paradise, and he made it available for the believers as long as they make dhikrullah. Who taught us about this? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Who are we benefiting now by coming to zikr from? Because of sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is sayyidul khalqi bila munasib. He is the master of all created beings. We need to know him and love him in order to be accepted. There's one accepted mold, role model in Allah's presence, and that is Sayyidina Muhammad. He is the perfect abd. Even all the prophets are modeled onto him. Everyone taking from him, salawatu Rabbi wa salamu alayhi. Because he is the Subhana alladhi asra bi abdihi. He is the real abd. And that's why Imam Busayri says about the prophets, وَوَاقِفُونَ لَدَيْ عِنْدَ حَدِّهِمُ. He said about prophets, اللهم صلى على سيدنا محمد, كَأَنَّهُ شَمْسُ فَضْلٍ هُمْ كَوَاكِبُهَا. He said he's like the sun and they are like the stars around. Like the moons, the kawakib around it, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They're all reflecting the light of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that's anbiya, those prophets. So all khair, all goodness coming to creation and coming to Ummah Sayyidina Muhammad because of that one. That's why awliya, how they become awliya? They become a reflection of sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They give up them their personality, they give up their ego, they give up their desires, and they only want what sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wants. They only want to do what sallallahu alayhi wa sallam does. They only want to live the way he lived, the way he is. And when they become like that, we used to go to see our mashayikh, and we used to believe when you're in their presence, you are in the presence of Sayyidina Muhammad. Because they are reflecting that light into this world. Salawatu Rabbi wa salamu alayhi. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us to be with these real men.
Ameen.
And grant us to honor Sayyid al-Khalq, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is so much one can say about him, about his perfections. But just to show how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala distinguished him from the prophets. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَإِذْ أَخَذَ اللَّهُ مِيثَاقَ النَّبِيِّينَ لَمَا آتَيْتُكُمْ مِنْ كِتَابٍ وَحِكْمَةٍ ثُمَّ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مُصَدِّقٌ لِمَا مَعَكُمْ لَتُؤْمِنُنَّ بِهِ وَلَتَنْصُرُنَّ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he took the pledge, mithaq, the promise of who? Of prophets. This is for someone who says prophets are dead. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he took their pledge. لَمَا أَتَيْتُكُمْ مِنْ كِتَابٍ وَحِكْمَةٍ. He said to them, whatever I've given you of books or of hikmah, of wisdom, of understanding. But when, if a prophet, ثُمَّ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ, and when a messenger, when that one, صلى الله عليه وسلم, when Sayyidina Muhammad appears, if you are there, you must, if that one appears and you are there, you must accept him, you must believe in him, you must support him. Allah is taking a pledge from whom? From the prophets, that your imam, if I send your imam, you must follow him. That's why sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu wa arda, he was interested to see comparative religion. He wanted to check what's in the Torah, so that he sees that the Torah that the Jews have coincides with the Quran and what they're saying. So he brought to Sayyidina Muhammad a page from the Torah, and when he showed Prophet ﷺ his face became turned. He became very upset. And he said to him, لو كان موسى حيا لما وسعه إلا أن يتبعني.
الله أكبر.
He said to him, why are you going to look at these things? He said, even if Musa عليه السلام himself was alive, he would have no choice but to follow me.
سبحان الله. صلى الله عليه وسلم.
He told Sayyidina Umar, this is Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And look how Allah in the Quran subtly shows his distinction. He said about him, Inna awhayna, wasta'idh billah, Inna awhayna ilayka. We have revealed unto you. He's in a class of his own. Kama awhayna ila Nuh wa nabiyyin. As we have revealed to Nuh and the prophets. But Allah distinguished. He says first, Inna awhayna ilayka, alone, by yourself. Then he mentioned the other prophets. And he mentioned, وَخَاطَبَ كُلَّ نَبِيٍّ بِإِسْمِهِ in the Quran. In the Quran, Allah mentioned, when he's addressing the prophets, he addressed them with their names. يا آدم اسكن، يا نوح اهبط، يا إبراهيم أعرض، يا موسى إني اصطفيتك، يا داود إنا جعلناك، يا عيسى ابن مريم، يا زكريا إنا نبشرك، يا يحيى خذ الكتاب. And he ولم يخاطب نبينا قط باسمه. He never addressed prophet with his first name. توقيرا showing his status. Every time he addressed him, يا أيها النبي، يا أيها الرسول. And only time the name of Sayyidina Muhammad is mentioned when it is mentioned in relation to the Risala. Say, Muhammadun Rasul. Not Ya Muhammad. Not addressing Muhammadun Rasul. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ. But not Ya Musa, as Allah addressing Sayyidina Musa, Ya Musa, Ya Isa. Never. Except Ya Ayyuhan Nabi. And this is Allah showing the distinction of your Nabi. This is Allah, His Creator, addressing Him like this. What about us? How much respect we must show Sallallahu Alaihi Wa Alaihi Wa. How much honoring we should give to that one. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us to honor that one. Inshallah we recite some short mawlid. Should we recite the English? Or what would you like? English for understanding?
As you wish.
Both. ما الذي أولياء الله يعينون بعون الله وكونوا عونا لنا بالله عسى نحظى بفضل الله. بريد ذنية إن شاء الله. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والله our intention for coming here together is to praise your beloved prophet and messenger. By doing so we intend to obey your order. Through doing so we seek your nearness and pleasure. والله we are also here because we are lovers. We hope to be lovers. Because we love your beloved Habib and wish to be with him forever. O Allah, we thank you for this magnificent honor. O Allah, grant us the power and ability to leave the delusion of thinking we have power or ability. To reach the conclusion that only you, Allah, have power and ability. O Allah, it is you who granted us success to gather here tonight to wash away our sins with showers of light and to taste the heavenly fruits of eternal delights. O Allah, we know we can never praise your beloved in befitting manner or come close to describing what you have bestowed on him of status and favor. For he is your beloved and you are Allah, the Lord of grandeur and power. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik alihi wa ala alihi.